number matches the 7 p.m. Pennsylvania Daily Pick 3 number, then you win. Order forms are available online, or you can contact the parish office center. Numbers are going fast, so don't miss out on all the fun. If you would like an end-of-year statement for your 2020 contributions to St. Mary Parish, please contact the parish office center. Please note that statements will not be sent out unless requested. We are still in need of people to fill our open adoration hours. Can you spend 1 hour a week with the Lord in our Divine Mercy Perpetual Adoration Chapel? Open hours are listed in the bulletin. Registration for Agnus Dei Academy for pre-K 3- and 4-year-olds and St. Mary's Catholic School for kindergarten through 8th grade are now open for the 2021-2022 school year. For more information or to schedule a personal tour, please contact Suzette at the St. Mary's School office. At this time, let us bow our heads in prayer to Our Lady of Guadalupe on behalf of our country and our world for a complete end to the coronavirus pandemic. Holy Virgin of Guadalupe, Queen of the Angels and Mother of the Americas, we fly to you today as your beloved children. We ask you to intercede for us with your Son, as you did at the wedding in Cana. Pray for us, loving Mother, and gain for our nation and world, and for all our families and loved ones, the protection of your holy angels, that we may be spared the worst of this illness. For those already afflicted, we ask you to obtain the grace of healing and deliverance. Hear the cries of those who are vulnerable and fearful. Wipe away their tears and help them to trust. In this time of trial and testing, teach all of us in the church to love one another and to be patient and kind. Help us to bring the peace of Jesus to our land and to our hearts. We come to you with confidence, knowing that you truly are our compassionate Mother, help of the sick and cause of our joy. Shelter us under the mantle of your protection. Keep us in the embrace of your arms. Help us always to know the love of your Son, Jesus. Amen. Today is the fifth Sunday in Ordinary Time. This Mass is being offered for Bridget Rigby, requested by John and Ed Cross. Our celebrant is Father Key. Our entrance hymn is Glory and Praise to Our God, number 548 in Breaking Bread. Please stand. Thank you.
Job spoke, saying, "Is not man's life on earth a drudgery? Are not his days those of hirelings? He is a slave who longs for the shade, a hireling who waits for his wages. So I have been assigned months of misery, and troubled nights have been allotted to me. If in bed I say, 'When shall I arise?' then the night drags on. I am filled with restlessness until the dawn. My days are swifter than a weaver's shuttle. They come to an end without hope. Remember that my life is like the wind. I shall not see happiness again." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, if I preach the gospel, this is no reason for me to boast, for an obligation has been imposed upon me. And woe to me if I do not preach it. If I do so willingly, I have recompense. But if unwillingly, then I have been entrusted with a stewardship. What then is my recompense? That when I preach, I offer the gospel free of charge, so as not to make full use of my right in the gospel. Although I am free in regard to all, I have made myself a slave to all, so as to win over as many as possible. To the weak, I became weak, to win over the weak. I have become all things to all, to save at least some. All this I do for the sake of the gospel, so that I too may have a share of it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. So he went into their synagogues, preaching and driving out demons throughout the whole of Galilee. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So in light of the weather outside this morning, you get a brief version of the homily. Now I have, and I want to just clarify, because I had a vigil mass last night, so I have a full homily. It was already given, but you're going to get the cliff notes. So this morning in the Gospel passage of St. Mark, we hear
sing. And the important aspect of this is twofold. One is his zeal for the encounter, right? For him to preach the word to them, to encounter them, and for them to be healed of their afflictions, physical afflictions, and those who were possessed. At the same time, we have to recognize in our own day that there has to be a desire on our part for that same profound moment of encounter with Christ Jesus. And to have that encounter allows us to recognize the things in our own life where we are possibly spiritually ill, or we've allowed ourselves to be possessed by something of the world that is keeping us from Christ Jesus. Many were brought to the Lord, and Simon Peter says, they're looking for you. And the same as it has to be the case for us as disciples of the Lord, we have to be looking for where are the moments that we can encounter the Lord Jesus, while at the same time being aware of the aspects of our own life that are preventing us from that encounter because of spiritual illness or possession of the things of this world that are not. Together let us profess our belief. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth,
of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God,
born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, we present our needs and petitions to our Almighty God, who sustains the lowly and heals the brokenhearted.
That the Church, the seed of the kingdom inaugurated by Christ, may be nourished by his grace to grow in unity and holiness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That government and public health officials may be granted wisdom and strength in their efforts to manage the pandemic, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the good news of God's kingdom may give hope to all those in misery and despair, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That this faith community may be blessed by the Spirit with joy, love, and peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the deceased of our parish, especially Elizabeth Principi, whose funeral mass is Wednesday, February 10th at 11 a.m., may be met by Christ in the fullness of God's kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us come in faith to the Lord, who graciously hears and answers our prayers, especially for Bridget Rigby, that she finds fulfillment in Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, in your goodness, hear and answer the prayers of those who cry out to you through your Son, Jesus, who is Lord forever.
Our offertory is number 422, Breaking Bread. How Great Thou Art, number 422.
Oh, Lord.
ministers that my sacrifice of yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the glory of his holy church.
Lord our God, who once established these sacred things to sustain us in our frailty, grant we pray that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of a virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory."
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy, religious, the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with
us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Our communion hymn is number 493 of Breaking Bread. We remember number 493.
We remember you.
prayers of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Our recessional hymn is number 562. Lift up your hearts, my